Toph Beifong might have invented metal bending, but her daughters perfected the art. Let's dive into Lin and Su Yin's bending and break down these masters of metal. First, we'll take a closer look at Lin.
Terrific.
As the eldest daughter of the legendary Toph, Lin had inherited all her mother's abilities. From her raw bending power, to her iconic seismic sense.
There's a tunnel beneath the workshop, running deep into the mountainside.
Toph taught Lin everything she knew, but teaching metal bending wasn't exactly a mother-daughter bonding experience. Toph was very tough on all her metal bending students, and Lin was no exception. But her training would pay off. Lin would follow her mother's footsteps and join the Republic City Police Force, and eventually became chief.
The investigation is ongoing. For the time being, we have frozen Mr. Ganlan's assets and are closing Cabbage Corp.
No! Not my Cabbage Corp!
During her crime-fighting career, she had several advanced metal-bending tools at her disposal. Toph designed a metal cable system that allowed cops to restrain criminals across longer distances. They could also be used to navigate the city quickly. Not even the Avatar could have escaped them. Even with all of the tools and gadgets, Lin's raw power is not to be understated. When the Equalist first rose to power, Lin was more than capable of taking down several at a time. Her speed and agility combined with her earthbending made her a one-woman army. Not to mention, she was absolutely fearless. She showed no hesitation to take on an entire airship. This level of raw power goes the same for her half-sister Su Yin. But she didn't exactly use her abilities to fight crime.
So you're robbing stores with the Terra Triad now?
I didn't steal anything. I just drove the car. I owed my friends a favor. It's not a big deal.
I'm not letting you get away with this.
Oh, what are you going to do, officer? Arrest me?
Don't even think about taking one more step!
To cover up her actions, Su Yin left Republic City behind. During her exile, she took metal bending to new heights, literally.
Wow, an entire city made of metal. Whoa, you should be right at home, Beifong.
With the help of an architect and soon-to-be husband, Batar, they built the city of Zaofu.
You know, before I built this city, there was nothing here. I wanted to make my mark on the world.
It's amazing.
Quickly becoming the metal-bending capital of the world, Zaofu pushed the limits of metal-bending. From creating skyscrapers, transportation, and even live performances.
Is this some kind of combat training?
Not exactly. They are rehearsing for a dance premiere next month.
That's it for today, everyone.
Just like her mother, Su Yin had plenty of students of her own who experimented with the possibilities of metal bending.
They're playing a game called Power Disc. They invented it all on their own. Oh, nice power, Wei. I'm so proud of those two.
She even helped Korra become the very first metal bending avatar.
Woohoo! Metal bending champion!
This was a side of bending that had never been seen before, and it would take 30 years for Lynn to see how far her sister came.
You're the one who tore our family apart.
And you've done a bang-up job keeping it that way.
The stress of seeing her sister again actually began to affect Lynn's health.
If you don't deal with your repressed feelings, there will be severe consequences to your health and your job. I know a great acupuncturist in town who will be able to help you.
Acupuncture is a real-life component of traditional Chinese medicine. And in Zhaofu, it's a central resource for metal-bending doctors. Much like Aang opening his chakras, Lin needed to unblock her qi flow.
I can't feel a thing.
That's unusual. Your qi must be powerfully blocked. We're going to need more needles.
The acupuncture tapped into Lin's memories from that day in Republic City, and it has been bottled up ever since.
I don't need to rest. I need to do something I should have done a long time ago.
Okay, I guess this is how it's going to be.
Should I stop them?
You don't have any siblings. Fighting is all part of the healing process.
Your system?
Not quite yet.
What are you two doing? You're sisters. Why would you want to hurt each other?
After they patched things up, the Beifongs became a full team. In the years that followed, the Beifongs and their prodigies developed all new metalbending techniques. We saw these new techniques on display when the Red Lotus rose to power.
Plea!
But their biggest challenge would come from a fellow metalbender, Kuvira.
Zhaofu is ours!
She was like a daughter to me. I took her in when she was 8 years old and nourished her talents. Kuvira turned my own son against me. And together they plotted behind my back.
Kuvira might have not been a Beifong by blood, but make no mistake, she possessed all the confidence and power of a true Beifong.
Looks like the Avatar is a little off her game.
Kuvira captured Suyin and her family during the siege of Zhaofu, which led to an epic rescue mission by Lin and Toph. Beifongs united, they faced off against Kuvira in one of the biggest earthbending battles ever. That wraps up Lin and Su Yin's Bending Evolutions. Who should we break down next? Let us know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe for all things Avatar.
So, how have you been, Mother?
I told you never to call me that.